Can we dim the lights a little bit, please? Can we dim the lights? عاوز اخفض النور شوية كان ممكن. Yeah. These are the indications for examination of the patient by CT. The most important one is to verify an equivocal finding seen on other imaging, like ultrasound, IVB, and barium studies, for example. If we see a lesion and we cannot reach the diagnosis, we got the help of CT. And there are a lot of indications other than this, but this, in my opinion, is the most important one. In order to examine the patient by CT, we used to give the patient this gastrographin solution. The value of this gastrographin solution is to opacify the bowel. Then we know that all these white things belong to the bowel. And if you give gastrographin and you can see some of the bowel containing gastrographin and other bowel does not contain gastrographin, then you know that this is a diseased bowel. Then we started the investigation based on this. And look also for this, you can see a mass here. And this mass contains, or one of the bowel loops is passing through the mass. Then you know that this mass is of bowel origin. And if you know that this is a small bowel, then lymphoma is the most likely diagnosis. If this is colon, then carcinoma is the most likely diagnosis. Then we put the patient on a CT machine like this, and we do a scanogram. The scanogram is just a plain X-ray for the area to be examined. And we say for the machine, we write, we would like to scan this area from the dome of the diaphragm until we reach the pubic symphysis. Then the machine will ask me about the interval of scanning, if 1 centimeter or half a centimeter or so. Then we scan the whole abdomen every 1 centimeter scan intervals. We take section, then after 1 centimeter we go and until we finish the whole examination. Then we may be interested only in this part of the abdomen, which is where the liver, the spleen, kidneys, and so on. But this is known as abdominal CT, and this is known as whole body CT. The body CT. And the body CT includes the abdomen as well as the valves. Then, after we starting sections, and you can see that this is the liver, this is the stomach with gastrographin inside, and this is the spleen. Look at this section, and you can see this is the liver, and here you can see the aorta and the IVC. The aorta contains contrast material, meaning that the patient is injected with contrast material. And can you see any focal lesion in this liver? Can you see? No. But look at the film taken before injecting the patient with contrast. And you can see multiple focal lesions in the liver. If you start your examination by injecting the patient directly with contrast, you have the chance to lose many of the focal lesions that can enhance as similar as to the liver parenchyma. Then we used to do our examination for the liver in particular before injecting contrast material, then after injecting contrast material. This is another example. This patient is injected with contrast and you cannot see any focal lesion in the liver, but the pre-contrast study, you can see a focal lesion in the liver. Then this is the CT machine. And you know, this is the gantry and this is the patient where the patient, this is the bed where the patient lies. If you open this gantry, and you will see a lot of machines. And in this, of these machines, the most important one is the X-ray tube and the detector. The patient is lying here in this section. Then in order to have a section in the human body, the X-ray tube and the detector have to rotate around the patient a full circle. And this was not feasible in the older machines because the tube was connected by the electricity cables to the ground. Then the tube moves half a circle, go back to parking, then move the other opposite circle and go back to parking. And in order to have an only one section in the human body, the machine, the tube and the detector have to move 4 times. Then at that time, the CT examination of the abdomen was performed in 75 minutes at that time. After this, another machine has been introduced, which is known as the spiral CT. This machine, the X-ray tube can rotate around the patient without stoppage because the electricity is delivered to the tube without cables. Then the tube can rotate full circle and the patient also moves while the tube is rotated. Then you got this spiral, and hence the name spiral CT. And this spiral CT has reduced the examination time to the fourth. Then instead of 75 minutes, you got about 20 minutes, for example, in the examination of the abdomen. After that, you got the most recent machine, which is known as the multi-detector machine. In the spiral CT, you have an X-ray tube and a detector, and you got a section every tube rotation. Then what happens if you put in front of the X-ray tube more than one detector? Let us say four. Then every rotation of the tube, you got four sections. Then you reduce the examination time into a fourth. And at that time, the detectors have been increased tremendously in front of the X-ray tube. We have machines with 16 detectors. We have machines with 32 detectors and 64. Then we have 128, and we have 256, and we have 320, and the latest one is 640. 640 detectors in front of the X-ray tube, and you can imagine the speed of this machine. It can examine the whole body from the head to toe in few seconds or less than 1 minute. Then, considering this fact, this is the CT scan of the abdomen before injecting contrast and after injecting contrast. How many lesions can you see in the liver? You may say, I can see one or two or three lesions. But look at this examination, which is the same patient. How many lesions can you see in the liver? You see too many lesions. And this is why, because we, by the use of these very fast machines, we are able to scan the liver while the contrast material is in the arteries. And you know that all focal lesions are supplied by the hepatic artery, while the normal liver parenchyma is supplied by the portal vein. Then in order to see the lesions in the liver parenchyma, you should scan the liver while the contrast material is in the arteries. And this was not feasible by the spiral CT. It is now feasible by the use of multi-detector machines. Then this is an example. This patient is injected with contrast on a conventional way, and you cannot see the focal lesion. Then look at the pre-contrast, you can see the lesion. Look at the arterial phase, and you can see the lesion very, very nicely. Then we consider all lesions taking contrast in the arterial phase as pathologic lesions in the liver. How can you know the arterial phase from the rest of the images? Look at the aorta. If you see the aorta is very bright, like similar to the spine, then you know that this is the maximal concentration of contrast material inside the aorta, then this is the arterial phase. And in starting to interpret the abdomen, we look first at the arterial phase in order to see any abnormality in the liver. Then let us go quickly in the anatomy of the abdomen. You know that this is the liver, and this is the spleen, and this is the stomach, and this is the aorta. And lower down, you can see this is the spleen, this is the pancreatic body and the tail, and this is the liver. This is the aorta, and this is the IVC. And you can see the aorta is surrounded by two thread-like structures, which represent the diaphragmatic crura, the crust of the diaphragm. Lower down, you can see the head of the pancreas, and you know that this is the head of the pancreas by this very important anatomic landmark, which is the superior mesenteric artery and the superior mesenteric vein. This is the head of the pancreas, and this is the duodenum adjacent to it. This is the gallbladder, this is the liver, this is the left kidney, and this is the right kidney. And you know that the left renal vein is coming out from the kidney anterior to the aorta until it enters the inferior vena cava. Then this is the head of the pancreas identified by the superior mesenteric artery and vein, and this is the common bile duct. And can you see this is a very small dot? This is the left kidney, and this is the right kidney. Then lower down, you can see left kidney, right kidney, part of the liver, and the intestine. And here you can see the aorta and the IVC and the intestinal loop. Lower down, you can see that the aorta is divided into two common iliac arteries, and also the inferior vena cava has two common iliac veins. Then you are left with the bowel loops in the abdomen. Lower down, there is difference between the male and female pelvis. In the male pelvis, you see the seminal vesicles and the rectum, posterior to the renal bladder, and lower down you can see the prostate, and here is the breast. While in the female, you can see the fundus of the uterus above the urinary bladder. Then the part of the uterus which is located between the urinary bladder and the rectum represents the cervix of the uterus. Here you can see the fundus is above the urinary bladder and then the cervix is behind the urinary bladder. Another case, and you can see this is the fundus of the uterus and this is the cervix posterior to the urinary bladder. Then if you draw a line between the IVC and the gallbladder, you can divide the liver into two lobes. The left lobe, this one, and the right lobe. The left lobe is divided into two segments by the fissure four ligamentum teres, lateral segment, medial segment. And the right lobe is divided into two segments by an imaginary line into anterior segment and posterior segment. Then if you look to the liver, you should not see any focal lesion. But if you have a CT scan with a lesion like this, this lesion is containing fluid. Then you know that this is a benign lesion. And benign lesions are four in the liver, while solid lesions like this one, and you can see these are solid lesions. Solid lesions are usually considered malignant, and malignant lesions are also four. The cystic lesions are the benign, the simple cyst, the hydatid cyst, the hemangioma, and the abscess. The four lesions that are malignant are hepatocellular carcinoma, cholangiocarcinoma, metastasis, and the lymphoma. These are the common lesions in the liver, and they are discriminated based on the density. If you see a fluid density, you consider benign lesion. If you see a solid density, you consider malignant lesion. And the differentiation is easy, but it is not the way or the time. Then look at the liver. The liver density should be similar to that of the spleen. If you see that the liver is slightly black compared to the spleen, this is fatty liver. And fat may be mild and may be severe. And this is fatty liver because the density of the liver is black compared to the density of the spleen. Then if you look to this liver, and you can easily diagnose cirrhosis because the liver is shrunken with nodular outline, this is cirrhosis. But look here, if you can see that the liver is bright than the spleen, then you know that something has been added to the liver parenchyma, which is glycogenous storage, hemochromatosis, hemosiderosis, and these are the possibilities whenever you see the liver is brighter or more denser than the spleen. Then, if you look to the liver, you can see contrast-filled vessels, but you cannot see any black lines through the liver. Whenever you see black lines through the liver, these are representing dilated biliary ducts. And then you diagnose that the patient had biliary obstruction, and you look for the site and the cause of obstruction. This is normal liver, and you can see vessels only through the liver, but you cannot see dilated biliary radicals. And this is another case of obstructive jaundice, where you can see dilated biliary radicals in a case of obstructive jaundice. Then, this is what we call the CT portography. And in the previous days, we used to introduce a needle in the spleen, injecting contrast material to see the portal vein. This was a very dangerous technique and may frequently was complicated by subcapsular hematoma in the spleen and maybe splenic rupture. But now you inject the contrast material intravenously and you order the multi-detector CT to scan the portal vein. Then after scanning the portal vein, you can remove all undesired structures like the liver, stomach, pancreas, and so. Then you are left with the splenic vein, the portal vein, and the superior mesenteric vein. This is a very good technique to demonstrate abnormalities of the portal vein, like thrombus in the portal vein or esophageal varices in cases of liver cirrhosis and splenomegaly. Then the pancreas is lying obliquely in the abdomen. Whenever you are coming from up down, then you can see the pancreatic body and the tail, then you can see the head lower down. And sometimes you can see the whole pancreas if it lies horizontally. This is the pancreatic tail body and the head of the pancreas. And you know that the splenic vein is crossing posterior to the pancreatic tissue. This is the normal pancreas, and this is the normal pancreas in old age. Pancreas in old age will be atrophic and infiltrated by fat, and this will not affect the pancreatic function, and it will function normally, but this is a normal appearance. This is not an abnormal appearance. And this is the normal pancreas with normal fat blains around. If the pancreas is swollen and the fat glands are dirty or congested, then you know that this is acute pancreatitis. Then look for the suprarenal glands. They are like the inverted Y. And this is the left suprarenal gland and this is the right suprarenal gland immediately above the kidneys. This is the left one and this is the right one. And here, this is the left suprarenal gland and this is the right suprarenal gland in a characteristic configuration. Then masses in the kidney are similar to the masses in the liver. If the mass is cystic, you consider benign lesion. If the mass is solid, you consider malignant lesion. And in this case, with a solid mass in the kidney, you use the facilities of multi-detector CT. Then you can see the mass is arising from the lower bowl of the kidney. And using the angiographic technique of the CT, you can see that the mass is malignant and is supplied by malignant circulation. This is an example of a benign lesion in the kidney containing water. And this is an example of a malignant lesion in the kidney containing soft tissue. This is the renal cell carcinoma, and this is simple renal cyst. And sometimes you got the two lesions in the same kidney, a simple renal cyst and the tumor in the same kidney. Then you can easily differentiate between simple renal cyst, which contains water, from a malignant lesion in the kidney, which represents a renal cell carcinoma. Then lower down in the abdomen, you can see intestine filled with gastrographin or contrast material. And here you can see the ureter anterior to the psoas muscle. This is the psoas muscle, and this is the ureter on both sides. Then few words about an important technique which can be performed by the use of multi-detector CT, which is known as virtual endoscopy. Virtual endoscopy meaning that you can go through any part of the body by a virtual endoscope, which is exactly similar to the endoscope with few differences. If we would like to do a virtual colonoscopy, then we prepare the patient adequately to remove all fecal matter. Then the patient came to the CT room and we inject some air inside the colon to distend the colon in order to go through the colon. Then we scan the abdomen, we can see the colon which is filled by air. Then we order the CT to subtract all undesired structures and we are left with the colon only. Then you got this image, which is performed by CT, which is known as CT colonography. Then in order to see the, I will show you how can you go through this this colon by the virtual endoscope and like this. And you put the cursor on the beginning of the colon at the anal canal, and then you push the button which is on the keyboard of the machine of the virtual camera. Then the virtual camera will open. Then you can move your cursor like this. While moving your cursor like this through the colon, then you got the images on the other screen. Then you can go inside the colon like I'm going. Then you look carefully inside the colon until you hit the wall of the colon. Then you have to realign the camera and go like this into the colonic lumen once more. And here's the adjustment of the camera, and you can go like this. And you proceed through the colon until you reach you examine the whole colonic segments until you reach the region of the cecum. And you know that everyone who is above 50 years of age should scan the colon or should screen the colon once per year. And there are three ways for evaluation of the colon. Number one, the barium enema. Number two, the real endoscope. And number three, this virtual endoscope. And the virtual endoscope is the most easy one of them. And the patient is in his home while we are doing this processing on the machine itself. Then if we came to the end of this lecture, and I have some of the questions for you, and what do you think about this structure? Yes, this is the pancreas, and this left kidney, and this one, yes, left suprarenal gland, and this is the portal vein at the hilum of the liver. And what do you think this structure? The spleen. And what is this part of the liver? Right lobe. Yes, posterior segment of the right lobe. And this? Left lobe, lateral segment. Very good. Then what do you think about this structure? Do you think this is a prostate or this is the cervix of the uterus? Yes, very good. The prostate is below the renal bladder, while the cervix is posterior to the renal bladder. This is the cervix, and this is the rectum, okay, and this one, urinary bladder. Very good. Number one is the liver. Number two, the stomach. Very good. Number three, very good, the spleen. And this is the, no, this is the diaphragmatic, yes, very good. This is the diaphragmatic crura, and this is the aorta. Very good. What do you think of this structure? Ureter, yes, very good. And aorta and colon or intestine with gastrographin inside. What do you think is the diagnosis of this case? Yes, very good. This is fatty liver because the density of the liver is relatively black compared to that of the spleen. This is fatty liver. And what do you think the diagnosis here? Yes, biliary obstruction or obstructive jaundice. Then what is this structure? No, this is the seminal vesicle. The prostate is below the urinary bladder. This is the seminal vesicle on the left side, and this is the right seminal vesicle. What is this? Urinary bladder, and this? Rectum, very good. Then what do you think the diagnosis of this renal? Yes, very good. This renal cell carcinoma, and this focal lesion in the liver? A benign lesion. Very good. And this is the end of my book. Thank you very much.